Tennessee, happy top Tennessee.
Once two strangers climbed a rocky top looking for a moonshine still. Strangers ain't come down from rocky top, reckon they never will. The corn won't grow at all on rocky top, dirt's too rocky by far. That's why all the folks on rocky top get their corn from a jar.
Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee, Rocky Top, Tennessee.
Back to the being intentional, with purpose and being prepared. It starts with everything that we do. Not only on the performance side, but mindset. The first things we do, now, being intentional means doing things to elevate and enhance the task that you're doing by adding extra attention to detail, more purposeful actions, it's to build more value and connection, if anything. So starting with your mindset, what do you do when you wake up? First thing you roll out of bed, a lot of us is looking at our phones. Now that often means, oh, what mess am I going to have to pick up? Or what negative thing in the political world these days? And that automatically sets you in that feeling of, oh, now I'm in fight or flight mode, or I'm in have to fix a problem mode. Other people that might wake up, they may go around the treadmill, they might do yoga. Do things to get your mindset correct. Being intentional about everything you do, and of course that carries out through everything else in your day. Mindset and perspective, very, very important. And of course, then it carries into your business side. I put mentor pods there because, raise your hands, who's familiar with mentor pods? Great. It started by Matt Rosselli. It's an amazing, amazing group that you can Google it, you can figure it out, find out. A lot of DJs are now doing it. It helps with a lot of the business side of things. Now, most of my two seminars this week are going to be based on performance and things that you can do to elevate your performance on the business side. One thing that I'm sure a lot of people that, like myself, have an issue is that when you are a really good performer, you often slack on the business side of things. It's like being a really good athlete in high school. You don't have to practice as much, it becomes natural, which can carry you to a point. But hopefully you have goals and your dreams to go much higher and elevate. And when you get to a certain point, then you have to have those systems in place, you have to have financials. That's a weakness of mine. Because I was, and I say this in a very humble way, because I was a really good performer, I was able to get away with stuff on the back end of the business side, the financials, the spreadsheets. Someone said earlier, you've got to know your numbers. These things that now I've expanded into a bigger team and doing higher end events and different stuff, you have to know this stuff. So mentor pods is just a direction. If you're curious on ways to elevate your business, that is one way to do it. I just added this line, raise your prices, 30 minutes ago. Because so far today, I've heard a lot of people say, raise your prices, go out and raise your prices. Well, sure, that's correct. But I think it's not just raising your prices. It's raising your performance. It's raising your value. You take care of those things, the prices will take care of itself. Because if you just raise your prices and you don't improve your performance, you don't improve your value, you don't improve your perception of what people think of you, your potential clients, you might be doing yourself a disservice. So we're not just going to raise our prices, we're going to raise our performance. And in these seminars, I'm going to try to give you as many easy to take away tips that you can implement tomorrow. Things that you can implement immediately, and it's designed for the mobile DJ. It's not going to teach you how to push play, how to beat match in that regard. It's going to take the people that are already experienced, like you in this room right now, hopefully take you to the next level. So that is the goal. Raise your prices. Your performance has to be able to match what your price selection. Song selection is our food. I want to just preface with this because this is important that you never forget this. You could have the greatest technical DJ in the world, but if they're not playing the right music, it's awful for that. You could have a DJ that does not mix at all, that's literally playing a playlist on Spotify, but if it's the right music, it's better than what I just said for most applications. So don't forget that song selection is the most important thing. However, to get to the top, to elevate your performance, to increase your profits. In 2024, I believe that you will want to have elite level mixing skills, or at least there are at least getting better at what you're doing, improving your performance, improving your performance, and that's why we're here today. We all want to improve our performance. I can't make you an amazing turntablist. I can't turn you into the next DJ Rogoza, or the next Even Steve, or the next Jazzy Jeff in an hour seminar, no. So my goal with this is going to give you some tidbits and takeaways and things that you as an average mobile DJ can do today, can do tomorrow, that will help elevate your sets without having 10,000 hours of knowing how to do this.
And see who they used last year and where and what they had in the order and how much it was and what their hot buttons were and what worked for them. And boy, doesn't that just give you so much ammo. Our wedding clients don't have that same history, do they? More often than not, right? I mean, Audrey and I are each other's third at last. But, you know, that's not necessarily true for you. But it's, you know, that we don't have that history with the client, right? And so what can we do? And so what I'm going to talk about are some things you can do to come in prepared and have the information you need to make it unique and personal to them. So we're going to start with the word research. Research. Definition is to make an extensive investigation into. When a client contacts you and says, hey, I'd like to talk about doing my wedding, I find that the more I know about them before we can talk about their needs and what I can do for them, the better off I'm going to be. Just like when I show up at the wedding. I got a statement that I borrowed from Randy Bartlett because I absolutely love it. He said, I've never shown up at a wedding and felt too prepared. The more prepared I am, the better job I can do. The less stress I have, the more in the moment I can be, and the more I can do creative things that are going to make it great. Chris, big props to you, dude, for showing that video. Audrey was with me on a wedding that I did in Kansas City on 11-11-11. Trust me, I'll never forget that date. And when you talk about being prepared, I got in the habit of writing my scripts the morning of. And so I had written my script for the grand entrance, and we were doing the Who's Being Introduced Next format, where you say something and that person steps forward because they know it's them, and then you finish with their name. Well, because I'd written it so last minute, somehow I deleted the guy's name. He's one of the groomsmen. He's one of the groom's brothers, but I didn't have it memorized, right? And so I got to the end, and I'm looking for the name, and I'm switching the page, and I'm going back, and I can't find it. And I go, you know who you are, get over here. Well, I pull up the ceremony music and look, and I find his name, and I finally say his name when he's already over hugging the bride and groom. And for the next 6 months, Ron and Audrey will both go, you know you are, get over here. Yeah, I screwed the pooch on that one. 9 months later, I talked to the bride, and I'm like, I couldn't believe I screwed that up. She's like, you did? She didn't even notice. But I noticed, and what it taught me was, doing that stuff last minute is never safe or effective. It also taught me that it's a good idea to have pictures of my VIPs in the paperwork. And that way I know, oh, that's that guy. Here's his photo right here. Here's his name right here. Makes it a whole lot easier to remember who I'm dealing with. Because I forget names. I mean, I had to have a few of you remind me. It's been a couple of years, right? Wes came walking in like, hey, Wes, take a minute, right? Sorry, it's the way it is. And so here I'm at a wedding with a bunch of strangers. Having their pictures can make all the difference in the world. So I started learning that doing research was going to make a difference not only in my performance, but also in my sales presentations. So it's important to learn what your clients value and what their values are and how they value things. These are very important steps to do. And this was supposed to be showing you my presenter notes, and it's not. Yay, hang on a second. Sorry, see if I can get that fixed.
You know who you are.
Yeah, I know. You know who you are, get over here. I had the presenter notes all done. Shoot, presenter notes. Okay, let's try this again and see if they show up. And they're not showing up. That's fantastic. All right. Well, you always got to have backup. Audrey, can I have my phone real quick? Thank you so much, Audrey Mary. My book, that's when you're supposed to take a shot. It's not when somebody else mentions a book, it's when Peter Mary mentions his book. That's me. This book is just coming out in the bookstores, and Ron Ruth had lined me up with a speaking engagement, and Audrey was the one who actually got the location taken care of for. So, what are we going to research? We're going to research, first of all, the couple. Where can you research the company?
Social media, Facebook.
Social media, Facebook, what else?
Wedding website.
Wedding website, right. How many couples have a wedding website? You do a search with both their names and the wedding date. Chances are, if they got a wedding website, you're going to find that. What do you find on the wedding website?
Registry. Wedding party.
Registry. Often the wedding party. What else? Sometimes their story. Right? How powerful is it to have that information ahead of time? But maybe they got, you know, just a Facebook profile or an Instagram profile. And what can those things tell you? It can tell you what their music likes are. It can tell you what their connections are. It might tell you what their career path currently is. Those are all valuable things that can give you insights into who they are and how they are.
Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Once two strangers climbed old Rocky Top looking for a moonshine still. Strangers ain't come down from Rocky Top, reckon they never will. The corn won't grow at all on Rocky Top, dirt's too rocky by fall.